There's really a lot of natural beauty in Baltimore City that most people will never see. There's so many streams crisscrossing their ways through the city. Even though those streams look clean and they look clear and it looks like you could go catch crayfish and swim in them and have a great time, they're still contaminated with fecal bacteria. The reason why sewage is so prevalent in Baltimore City is because we have such an old sewer system. So all of those leaky pipes are letting sewage flow into our waterways and into the stormwater system, which eventually just flows into our waterways as well. We have so much impervious surface in the city that every time we get a rain, you know, this just flash floods. It's crazy. Today we're monitoring water quality throughout the Jones Falls and all of its contributing tributaries in order to figure out how healthy the streams are. 500. So we're taking different measurements of different water quality parameters and taking whole water samples to be analyzed later so that we can really figure out whether or not it's safe to touch the water, safe to swim in the water, and what the water quality is really like. There's really four major pollutants in Baltimore City that are affecting water quality. That's sewage, stormwater pollution, trash, and toxics. Our monitoring doesn't really pick up on the trash or toxics aspects of water quality, but we're really able to figure out if the water quality is being affected by issues like stormwater runoff and sewage. Water quality is a huge issue for us, and it's something that ties the whole city together because it's something that we're all dealing with regardless of race or class or anything else. There's not that sort of social buy-in to the waterways in our area because people have no idea they even exist.